Hello friends, how are you? Welcome to Sunil Engineering Academy. I am Bharat. We are looking into the Polity series of lectures and this is Polity class 4. We are dealing with salient features of the constitution. You can find the PDF in the description box. The link is given, friends. Okay. The salient features of the constitution as it stands today are as follows. What is Constitution of India? See friends, in simple words, if we have to say what is Constitution of India, if we purchase any equipment, electronic device or any machinery, you will be given with the manual. And manual has a set of rules and regulations how to work with it. Okay, in the same way, our government has one manual how the system works. Okay, that manual is called Constitution of India, friends. Okay, what are the features or salient features of that constitution we are looking into? The first one is the lengthiest written constitution, friends. Yes, in the world, the constitution, our constitution is the lengthiest constitution which we are working with. And we have to know that there are two types of constitutions. One is written constitution like America's and unwritten constitution as British. And Indian is a written constitution. Indian constitution is a written constitution. And in that written constitutions is one of the, is the, it's not one of the lengthiest constitutions. It is the lengthiest constitution of the world. It is very comprehensive, very elaborate, and it is a detailed document, friends. Okay, but from where we have got all these inputs? So we have got these inputs from various sources, friends. Okay, our Constitution of India has borrowed most of its provisions from the constitution of various other countries, friends. Okay, our drafting committee, which is headed by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, has gone through all the constitutions at that time and they have took some of the important things from some of the countries' constitutions. Okay, first thing you have to remember is that 60% of the Indian constitution have been taken from the Government of India Act 1935, which we have already discussed, friends. Okay, now we have discussed what is Government of India Act 1935. Okay. And there are many things, many countries which influenced our Indian constitution. Those are fundamental rights. This is very, very, very important, friends. Various sources, direct questions will be asked from this part of the. If we take fundamental rights is borrowed from which country, the direct question comes like this. USA, UK, Ireland, Canada, something like that. Okay. So you have to remember fundamental rights, integrated judiciary system, judicial review, public interest litigation, impeachment procedure of the president, and preamble. All these have taken from USA. See, what you have to remember is that judicial review is taken from, okay, it is from USA. PIL, public interest litigation, it's taken from USA. Impeachment procedure of the president, it's taken from USA. Preamble, USA. Fundamental rights, USA. Okay. And DPSP, directive principles of state policies, it is taken from Ireland, friends. And method of election of president, see, election of president is taken from Ireland. Whereas impeachment means removal of the president. To remove the president, there is one procedure and that procedure is called impeachment, friends. Don't worry if you don't know anything. What is a DPSP, sir? What is fundamental rights, sir? Or how the president elections are happening? How the president is elected? All these we are going to discuss in coming lessons. Okay, just remember the terminology as for now and from which country we have borrowed it from. Okay, federal system with strong center is from Canada, friends. Okay, residual powers rest with the union, appointment of the governor. Appointment of the governor is also taken from the Canada. Japan, we have taken rule of law from Japan, concurrent list from Australia, provisions regarding trade and commerce is also taken from Australia, friends. Socialistic principles from Russia, fundamental duties from Russia, whereas fundamental rights is from USA, friends. Plans, these plans are 5-year plans, friends. 5-year plans, we have that model of planning is copied from the Russia. Germany, fundamental rights, abolition of fundamental rights during emergencies. Of course, fundamental rights are taken from USA. In Germany, they have a procedure to abolish the fundamental rights during emergency period, friends. That abolition of fundamental rights during emergency is copied from Germany. Okay, from UK, we have taken many things, friends, because we know that British ruled India. So most of the parliamentary system, speaker, conduct is the head over the parliamentary assembly. That single citizenship, president is the nominal head, as the queen is the nominal head in British election commission. Everything we have copied it from the British, friends. Okay, and South Africa, procedure of constitutional amendment act, how the if there is any changes. See constitution was made back in 1950, friends. Okay, and there are many changes that we see in the modern world. If we want to change any act in the constitution, then what is the procedure to change that act is taken from South Africa. Procedure to change the constitution, procedure to change the acts, constitution through Constitution Amendment Act 368, friends. This is also important. So you have to remember this at any cost. You have to remember this, friends. Don't worry. The PDF is available down in the description box. Okay. So the third one is, our constitution is not rigid, completely rigid, not completely flexible, friends. Okay. Ours is not completely rigid. Ours is not completely flexible. What is rigid, what is flexible is that rigid, whatever is written in the constitution, it should be followed the same way. That is rigidity. Flexibility is there is no written constitution at all. Like we can see in UK, there is no written constitution. Then and there they will form an act and they will proceed. So we have written constitution, but we can change that acts in the constitution through Constitution Amendment Act. So we say that it is a mixture of rigidity and flexibility, neither rigid nor flexible. We go in the middle path, friends. Okay, you just read this, then you will understand. Federal system with unitary bias. What is federal system with unitary bias? If you take USA, there are many states in USA, United States of America. Okay, friends, these all states come together and they form USA, friends. Okay, united, they form a country called USA, but that is called federal system, friends. And but the actual power lies with the state itself. But in India, all states come together to form India, but the ultimate power lies with the center, not with the states, friends. See here, Punjab, Haryana, Delhi, Uttar Pradesh, Uttarakhand, all this come together and form all the 29 states come together and form a country, but the final say will be with the center, that is the central government. But in USA, the final say will be in the hands of the individual states, friends. Okay, that is what they are saying. The Constitution of India established a federal system of government. It contains all usual features of the federation, two government systems, state government system, central government system, and there are division of powers. See, the state has certain powers, central has certain powers, whereas state has police, center has army. the example what we can say. A written constitution is there, supremacy of the constitution. Always the what is the constitution says that will be followed, friends. Rigidity of constitution, independent judiciary and bicameralism, friends. Okay. However, Indian constitution also contains a large number of unitary and non-federal features, strong center. Of course, this federation system is not completely manifested in our India, friends. Federal system in the sense, the state should be having the ultimate power, that is federal system. But what we say is that federal system, we have federal system, but with unitary bias, unitary in the sense that our center has more power. We have given more power to the center. That is why we say that federal system, but with unitary bias. That is, the center will be having the more power. So we know that all the we have strong center, single constitution, single citizenship, flexible constitution, integrated judiciary. Even in judiciary also you can see that high courts will be there. High courts is the final court for state level, but if there is any issue in the high court, we can go for the Supreme Court, which is again a central court. Whereas in USA, whatever the high court which is in the state says, that is final. There is no other court higher than the state court, friends. Okay, so the high court in the United States, that is one state, in one state, if the highest court in one state says something, some judgment, there is no other petition to go for another bigger court. But whereas in India, Supreme Court, we can review in the Supreme Court, friends. Okay. The appointment of the state governor by the center, All India Services. So these are the powers which have which center has in its hold. They can appoint the governor, they can appoint the collectors. In their hands they have some control, friends. With that control, they are controlling the, they have more powers than the state. In emergency policies also, emergency provisions also given for the center. They can take over any state, friends. Okay, under certain conditions only. So parliamentary form of government. The Constitution of India has adopted British parliamentary system of government rather than American presidential system of government, friends. The parliamentary system is based on the principle of cooperation, coordination between the legislative and executive organs, while the presidential system is based on the doctrine of separation of powers between the two organs, friends. So we go for the parliamentary, it is self-explanatory. We go for the British parliamentary system rather than the American presidential system. Americans believe that there is a doctrine of separation. You go your way, we will go our way. But in parliamentary system, both cooperation should be needed for them, friends. Okay. So, in parliament, we adopt parliamentary system of government. See, friends, if you have two independent bodies, we have an issue in India. If you have any issue in India, see, parliamentary system is there. Parliamentary system in the sense Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha and President. Okay. In other side, judicial system is there. We have high courts, we have Supreme Courts. Okay, Supreme Court, friends. Judges, we have Chief Justice of India. Okay. See, in British Parliament, here in British Parliament, we can see the parliamentary supremacy. You see, Parliament, what it says, it is the final. Whereas in American Supreme Court, judicial supremacy. See, whatever the Supreme Court says, that is final, friends. Okay. But what we have in India, both has equal powers. We can say that both have equal powers. Synthesis of parliamentary sovereignty and judicial sovereignty. We can't say one is high and another is higher than the other, but we can say that synthesis, both combines to be supreme, friends. Okay, just as the Indian parliamentary system differs from the British Parliament. We differ from the British Parliament. We say that a parliamentary system is not the supreme. In the same way, we don't agree with the US also. In US, Supreme Court has the final say, friends. We don't agree with the Supreme Court, but we have judicial review in Supreme Court, where they have is narrower scope. We have given some scope to take over the parliamentary decisions, friends. Okay. This is because the American Constitution provides the due process of law contained in the Indian Constitution, friends. Okay. So we don't give full supremacy to the parliamentary system. We don't give full supremacy to the judicial system, but we have equal importance for parliament as well as the judiciary, friends. So we say that synthesis of parliamentary sovereignty and judicial supremacy, friends. Okay, I hope you have understood this one. Integrated and independent judiciary. In judiciary, we have seen that in United States of America, the state high court, whatever it says, it is the final, friends. Of course, they are independent from other high courts or from other states. But if there is an issue between the states, we go for the Supreme Court. And also, if there is any, if we are not satisfied with the judgment of from the High Court, we can go for the Supreme Court, friends. So it is an integrated, and also independent judiciary, friends. So you have to understand. Please go through this. It will be self-explanatory. And you have to remember that whatever it is, whatever the laws that is passed in the Supreme Court is applicable in the high courts. Whatever the laws that is passed in the high courts, it also applicable in the district courts and the courts which come under the jurisdiction. Fundamental rights. See, we will see the fundamental rights as a separate class. As of now, we have fundamental rights, which is a salient feature of our constitution, friends. Many countries doesn't have these rights, friends. If you can see in Middle East, in communist countries, we don't find these rights. But we have these kind of rights. We are so fortunate to be born in India, friends. So we have mainly right to equality, right to freedom, right against exploitation, right to freedom of religion, cultural and educational rights, right to constitutional remedies. The fundamental rights are meant for promoting the idea of political democracy. Democracy in the sense rule of a people, friends. So people has the right to do their will, friends. Okay. Directive principles of state policies. This DPSP has taken from Ireland, friends. Ireland has taken it from Spain, that you have to remember. According to Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, DPSP is a novel feature of the Indian Constitution. They are enumerated in the part 4 of the Constitution. We will see what are parts, what are schedules in the coming classes. They can be classified in 3 broad categories. What is this DPSP? Is that it is socialistic, Gandhian and liberal intellectual content that we follow in our constitution. Mainly our constitution is driven by socialistic ideas, Gandhian ideas and liberal intellectual ideas. But these are just the directive principles to the state policies. See, center is directing. We can understand that directive principles in the sense center, that is our constitution of India, directs the states to formulate the policies in according to socialistic, Gandhian and liberal way. Are you understanding, friends? Center is directing the state to form the policies to have principles of socialistic, Gandhian, and liberal. Whatever the scheme you frame, whatever the social development programs that you make, those ideas, those implementation should be on the lines of socialistic, Gandhian, and liberal ideas. They are saying in the same way. For the, they say that in one word, they will say that for the welfare state. They seek to establish welfare state for the sake of welfare state. This one word welfare state means DPSPs, all these socialistic, Gandhian, liberal intellect ideas will come into one word, that is welfare state, friends. Okay. Yes, next comes the fundamental duties, friends. See, from next class we will see the rest of this class. We will see the fundamental duties: secular state, universal adult franchise, single citizenship, independent bodies, and emergency provisions, friends. And finally, three-tier system. These, all this we will see in the class 5, friends. Till then, take care. Don't forget to download the PDF and also go through our website, Sunil Engineering Academy. From there, you can download all other PDFs of other classes, friends. Okay. Thank you. Bye-bye.